The man convicted of killing Jessica O'Grady 6 years ago appeals to the Nebraska Supreme Court. Last year, Chris Edwards' request for a new trial was denied by a Douglas County District Judge. The argument? That Dave Kofod, who helped investigate O'Grady's murder, planted blood evidence on several items, evidence that would help convict Edwards of murder. Christopher Edwards pins his appeal on some of the evidence collected from this Omaha home back in 2006. Prosecutors convinced a jury this is where Edwards killed Jessica O'Grady. But since no body was ever found, it was the blood evidence that made the case.
I would prove that the evidence was fabricated, that it was a violation of substantive due process.
Which part of the evidence? Not the mattress.
Not the mattress.
Edwards' attorney does not dispute the blood-soaked mattress from Edwards' bedroom. But he argued before the Nebraska Supreme Court that blood found on this battle sword and on garden shears was suspect because former Douglas County crime scene investigator Dave Kofod collected it. Brian Munnelly suggested Kofod planted it.
Did someone else examine the car besides Kofod?
Somebody had examined the car the day before Kofod. Douglas County sheriffs did it just like they had in the Murdoch case.
And they didn't find anything?
Didn't find anything.
Kofod went to prison, convicted of tampering with evidence in the Murdoch, Nebraska murder case. But arguing for the state, Assistant Attorney General Kimberly Klein said even without the evidence in question, there was enough to convict Chris Edwards.
If you take this evidence out as if it had never been presented to a jury, would he still have been convicted? And the answer is absolutely yes.
A judge has already rejected one request by Edwards for a new trial. Now his attorney hopes the Supreme Court will find enough questions to warrant a hearing on the evidence.
We'd like to just get an evidentiary hearing, an opportunity to present our claim in district court. That's what we're asking for.
Edwards is serving a 100-year sentence for second-degree murder. The state Supreme Court will take these arguments under advisement and issue a ruling at a later date.